Standing under the barbed wire fence by the railroad ties.
Yeah, it's shutting down. It's going into protect mode.
All right. That's the ups and downs of speaker building. Sometimes things don't work out as planned, right? All right, so I've snipped those wires on that resistor for the piezo. So we're going to just run the straight piezo off the crossover and see what it sounds like. Like those tweeters. At this point, since I just slammed these together, I'm not sure what's causing it. Can only be the crossover or the tweeter. My money would be on the tweeter. Like I said, it was a super cheap tweeter. Main reason I got it was because of the look of it. I think what I'll do next, actually, next video, I think what I'm going to do is try to use, I'm going to repurpose the RCA tweeters. These were pretty loud. Yeah, I think that I can easily glue these on the back of those horns so I can, you know, basically take off the piezo and put this in there and have a regular tweeter going. We'll see if that fixes the problem. Before I go hunting down some problem with the piezo tweeter, or go into the trouble of cutting up a perfectly good tweeter to try to mock up something that works differently, I want to make sure, double check all my work, and make sure that there's nothing shorting out on the crossover. So I did find a couple of pieces of solder that were down there floating around by the positive and negative. And the other thing that I started thinking about overnight was I had had this crossover mounted on the stylus pad like this. You know, so this was on the back of the crossover, and this was down on the other side. And I got to thinking that this butyl is pretty soft. There's areas where you could see that the little soldering points on that circuit board were poking through. My thought was that maybe, you know, there was one that had actually made it through to the foil, which wouldn't be too hard to do. I would think if this was the case, if I had a direct short anywhere on the crossover, that I would notice it before listening to it for 10 or 15 minutes at low volume and then turning it up. But I just think it's best to double check all my work first. And I'm actually going to come up with a little bit different mounting system here. What I'm gonna do is actually cut out the stylus so that we're just working directly with the wood behind it to stop it from vibrating or resonating. I can still use this, but I don't wanna use it in such a way that you know, it's gonna touch the foil. So I'll probably just take this off of the foil, or take the foil off of the butyl, which I can do. It's not really easy, but I can do it. But just a little bit of it would help eliminate any vibration. So that's what I wanted to show you. Let's get to work.
Okay, so that kind of rework is done. And I call it rework because it's the original design intent that I had. I've got the piezo tweeter still in there. It's got the resistor that I had got for it to, you know, bridge across that to present an 8-ohm load to the crossover. The only thing I did different, honestly, was that I took the crossover board off of where I had mounted it, and I took all that sound deadener out from behind it and peeled off all the sound deadener from the foil, put it all back down, except smooshed it around on the wood, and then I mounted the crossover directly to the wood. So there's no chance of that thing shorting out. I was thinking overnight, what if those little protrusions from the back of the solder points on the back of that board are sharp enough and deep enough to go through that butyl and touch the foil? And that might have been causing an issue. I'm not sure. I've been listening to that speaker for probably about 20 minutes. No problem so far, but I haven't turned it up. And I just hooked up that speaker, so I'm about to turn it on and listen to it a little bit. So let's see what happens and see if I can actually turn it up this time around. At minus 10, if it's gonna go, it'll go now.
Just yesterday
or morning, soon.
They let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. My back turned towards the sun. No one knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end.
It's ready for digital. I was running it at minus 5 dB for, you know, the better part of the last 5 to 10 minutes, and no problems yet, so crossing my fingers here. Let's put it through its paces. I'm gonna throw on that Kurtz mix that had some of that music that we listened to back when the when these were in their stock form.
Gentlemen, welcome to the main event.
We're going minus 20.
Yeah. got that head busted. We need a dead cousin. What's up? I'm country boy, just say something. If you're ready, why you stumbling into the floor? Huh? If you're ready, why you stuttering? I ain't dumb. I'ma show 'em why they call it dirty. There is no mercy for player haters, cause he ain't worthy. Heard of me then? Hell no, my boy.
They've not tripped the protect mode yet, so that's a good thing. And I've been playing them pretty loud. We're gonna go to zero rep.
To the main event.
Wow, those things get loud. I'm serious, they get really loud. And honestly, the sound in here is not real bad. It's not shrilly or anything else. So I'm surprised. They don't have a lot of sharp highs, unless there's like some kind of cymbal or something going. And the, you know, the bass is the mid-bass driver, but it's hitting that bass pretty good. So as far as power handling, wow. I was running those things at 0 dB, which is like reference level on the NAD. And yeah, it was stupid loud. I'm sure you could run these things outside, no problem. I mean, they have a lot of output. Yeah, I mean, mini DJ speakers, maybe. They're only about 25 pounds a piece. So yeah, actually, if you were going the pro route, you know, probably a little bit better bass driver might even help out too. But wow, I'm impressed so far, and it has not tripped the that, you know, protect mode for the receiver. So I have a feeling that was simply that crossover being mounted onto that Silas and it was touching foil. That was it, or that little chunk of solder that was loose in there might have been touching one of those terminals. I'm not sure which. Something was shutting it down when I first tested them, and I went to all that work of pulling out the tweeters and cutting off the resistor and all that stuff, but I don't think I needed to. But yeah, they're definitely rocking.
We're gonna go gonzo here. 0 dB of the Dave Matthews Band. This is gonna be crazy loud. Sorry if it distorts on the camera.
Thank you.
storm outside, and the fire's bright. Oh, and in your eyes, I see what's on my mind. You got me wild, turned around inside. Oh, and then as I see it, it's creeping up the valley, all inside here.
Wow. Well, they're working, and I underestimated the piezo tweeters for sure. Yeah, my bad doing that build, man. I must have made a short somewhere, just enough to put that receiver into protect mode. Yeah, but I mean, right now, man, they're rocking. These things, they jam. I mean, they're loud and punchy. And they have some deep bass too, surprisingly. Yeah. With subwoofers? Holy cow, this thing would be crazy loud. You know what it reminds me of actually is, 20 plus years ago when I was going after the, I thought there might be a market for high power audiophile grade speakers. And so, yeah, I was building these high power loudspeakers, and I honestly, this fits in that kind of category. I mean, as far as like loud and clear and musical, yeah, they got it going on. I don't know how it came across on the phone, and I hope you had your headphones on or the home theater running or something, because that was pretty impressive. I think it was impressive anyway for what these are, and $100 8-inch two-way system, right? Yeah, pretty wild, man. Well, anyway, thanks for watching. I'm glad that you were here with me when I got them working and I figured out what the problem was. And now, I might still go ahead and try to modify a pair of those horn tweeters. The idea there was basically to cut off this, separate that piezo tweeter from the horn, and then try to glue a tweeter on the back. Which tweeter? I'm not sure yet. I got this RCA tweeter. I don't think it's a very high power tweeter, but it gets pretty loud. Yeah, it's pretty cool. They're working out. So for $100, let's see, is that about right? Well, figure $100 for the woofers if you had to buy them. These woofers are other ones, kind of similar quality. Another, say, $20 for tweeters. I spent $20 on the cabinets, like however much, $20 on Silas, $20 on crossovers, a few bucks on terminal cups. So I don't know, $100 a speaker, let's say. But man, that's bang for the buck there. Yeah, these things get crazy loud. Thanks for watching.